What is up, guys, and welcome back to the Zozums. It is me, once again, the only person who runs this YouTube channel, and today we are taking a look at the light tank M5A1 Stuart. This is a great light tank. I mean, for its battle rating, yes. Well, actually, yeah, it is a low-tier tank, and I don't really play low-tier tanks. But look at my American tech tree. Does it look like I have a choice? Yeah, okay. So, this tank is a great tank, to be honest. I mean, it has speed, sometimes it has the armor, it has a good gun, it doesn't have good fragmentate very well when you hit stuff with it, but it reloads fast so you can shoot things fast. Yeah, got enough excuse for me. it comes with a few machine guns. That also helps when you're fighting Flakpanzers or Gepards or... Okay, I give up. I may like this tank, but you may not. I don't know. Anyways, this thing is a great tank. As far as I'm concerned, if I remember correctly, this thing was designed to be an upgraded version of just the M3 Stuart, and it was also designed because the Americans needed a new light tank for World War II, not the M3 Stuart. So they basically took the M3 Stuart and just said, you know what, sloped armor, slightly larger turret, yeah. And they got this thing. Yep. History lessons with me. Whoop-dee-doo. Okay, so yeah, let's just look at this thing's armor. So frontal armor, we have 28 millimeters of frontal plate armor, and angled like it is, it's kind of, it's somewhere around 30 millimeters. And then we have this nice little layered spot. So this is I'm pretty sure this is in weak spot because it's layered like it is, because it has a 20 millimeters of armor right there, then it has 25 more millimeters of armor, so this probably is in a weak spot, but you have 25 millimeters of armor right here. Yeah. Glower Glacius, you have 35.5 millimeters of armor, which, angled like it is, gives you almost 100 millimeters everywhere, except for, like, right around here. Holy crap, 200 millimeters! Okay. Basically, this is not really a weak spot. Weak spot to be messed with. Okay, yeah, moving on to the size. So, this side armor, you have 28 millimeters. Top side armor, and also top rear armor is 28 millimeters as well. Whoop-dee-doo. Tracks count as an extra 10 millimeters of armor. These things count as 15 millimeters of armor, and so do the wheels. Yay. Reverse armor? Yes. Oh, you have these little tracks right here, 10 millimeters of armor right there. Then you have this, which is 25 millimeters of armor. Then you have that, which is 25 millimeters of armor. Yeah. Turret, we have for the front gun mantlet, we have 50 millimeters. The gun itself is 15 millimeters. The machine gun's 5 millimeters. Frontal of the turret is 44 millimeters. Side of the turret is 31.75 millimeters. Don't know why that's not 32. Then we have this thing to protect the, commander, while he shoots his machine gun, which is 12.7 millimeters of armor. Freedom. And then we have the tracks on the side of the turret over here. And then we have the rear of the turret, which is 31.75 millimeters along with more tracks. And then for the top of the turret, you get 12.7 millimeters of armor. And then the top of the tank itself is also 12.7 millimeters of armor. Yay. Also, in the newest update, if you guys haven't realized, you can get these new little prop things to put on your tank. So if you're like me, you just put two helmets and four jerry cans. Because, you know, jerry cans are awesome. To unlock the jerry cans, you have to set 20 things on fire. And to unlock the helmet, well, it differs for, stuff. So, say you wanted to get the gas mask. Well, you have to get you have to get 10 missions that you win with 80% battle activity to get that. For the steel helmet for the UK, you have to kill 50 players in the UK in ground vehicles. In ranks 2 to 5. No tier 1. To get this one, the tank helmet for UK, even though you have to unlock it using American vehicles, yay. You have to kill 50 players using Americans. To get the German one, you have to kill 50 players using Germans. And to get the Russian one, you have to kill 50 players using Russians. Very simple. You also get skulls, which you can purchase these for 500 golden eagles. Nobody's ever going to do that. Then you get signs, which you can purchase all these for 500 golden eagles. Then you get Randall's and Insignias, which you can also purchase for 500 golden eagles. And then you get the others, which are these, and then you can purchase these for 500 golden eagles. And then you get the camouflage, which nobody is going to like, because this is the last day that they are on sale for 500. They're going to be going up to 2,000 golden eagles and 1,000 golden eagles after today. Actually, yesterday, so this, by the time you guys are seeing this video, these will be at 1,000 to 2,000 golden eagles. Whoop-dee-doo. Also, just before this video starts, I'm switching to my channel to post-commentary, so I won't have to deal with all the lag while I'm recording. So I'm going to be showing you the replay file for two games, and I hope you guys enjoy it. So yeah, also, if you just tell me if you guys want me to go, tell me, okay, I want you guys to tell me if I should go back to just having normal commentary while I play over it, which is kind of distracting, and it lags me to death while I have this computer, and yeah. Or if I should just keep going with the post-commentary, if I should record the games and then do post-commentary, or if I should just do the replay files. Yeah, okay, do that in the comment section. So yeah, see you in the battle, I guess. Well, I won't really see you, but whatever, be quiet. Okay, guys, so here we are in the match that I got for this video. And we are on Eastern Europe in... Well, you know, the M5A1. I mean, why would I be in anything else if I'm playing the M5A1? Yeah, okay. So let's just dive straight into this. Now, my original plan was just kind of play this very cautiously, and don't get hit, and take out a few people. And that's kind of what I did for the first part of it, but it didn't really work for the last of it, if I may say myself. So, this is a domination on Eastern Europe, so the A point is the smack middle of the town, which is just great, if you know what I mean. So, I'm pushing up through the town, fastest, well, the first person. Okay, hold up, let me take this back. I am pushing really hard, as in I'm the only person this far up at the moment. So I'm kind of hesitating, do I go left or do I go right? So I've decided I'm going to go left. So if I was gonna go right, I was just gonna go and storm the A point. But I decided to go left because my favorite point to kind of camp, if you know what I mean, is over here. And yes, I do camp sometimes on this map, but that's because morons. So now I have to decide, do I want to take, okay, I'll just pause it. So do I want to take, look down that way, or this whole way? So I just kind of decide, well, I just clear them. So I look over this way, nothing to see. Great. Speed it up a bit. I kind of sit here for a while hesitating. Look over this way by using the camera glitch, nothing to see over there. So I decide to pop around this corner now. After I get a little bit of lag, because the server apparently didn't like me right there. So I go from being over here to smack in the middle of this wall. It's a miracle that I wasn't killed because a whole bunch of people will be over here in a second. So I decide, okay, time to push up around said corner right here. I don't see anything the first time I pop out, which is great. So I'm just like, okay, yeah, there's nothing here. Should I go for the A point? Now watch this martyr. I'm just completely oblivious to the martyr going right there. So I pop out again, and I see the Panzer IV F1, because my original plan was to go through this little alley there. Now the martyr doesn't see me yet, but soon enough he will. Now I decide to back up so I can shoot through the fence and kill the Panzer IV. And I put two shots into him before the martyr smacks one right into me, takes out two of my, crew members, sorry. So he takes out two of my crew members, and shortly later he is completely destroyed. Oops, So, I get my crew members back up, and I take out the Panzer IV. Now, I don't realize that... Well, actually, I'm repairing at this moment because my transmission was damaged enough. And this Eric Hartman dude takes out my turret. So now I am on last man standing mode. And if you don't know how to use this, it is very much a pain in the butt. And actually, I really hate it. And honestly, I would just rather play without this. But if you can use it right, you can do very well. So at this point in time, I'm just kind of sitting here not knowing what to do. Because there's a Panzer III there that I can see. So I try to kind of side-scrape there. He takes out both my fuel tanks, which doesn't really work for me. And I decide to take up this position right here, thinking, well, he could come around the corner. No, he's not going to come around the corner. Why would he do that? So he does push up a little bit, but instead he decides to go around that way behind that house. And I decide to push up here, and I can see the 72K Gauss. Now, I'm starting to look for shots. Actually, no, I don't see the 72K Gauss yet, but now I do. So I take a shot, do no damage whatsoever, take another shot, take out his engine, take another shot, take out three of his crew members, and take another shot, doing absolutely nothing, use a machine gun, and finally completely destroy him. So I kind of sit here again being cautious for a while. I'm watching both sides of this building. I'm watching this side and this side. Now I get pissed at this rod right here because I'm like, okay, why are you screwing my view? Now the Panda 2C comes along. I'm like, wait, what? And I pop one in, completely destroy two of his members, and I light him on fire. The Crusader tries to take a pop at him, but in a few more shots, I get him to the point where he's dead. So that's another kill for me. It's three at this point. Now, the 75mm M3 GMC is pushing up now, and there's nothing in the vicinity that can hurt me. So, I see the Stuggy, the same guy from the Panzer III, and deciding, okay, yeah, I can push up here, and I can get a shot into him. No, he shortly blows up right before I switch to my gunner. So I'm just like, okay, look around a bit, make sure there's nothing to come and destroy me. And there isn't anything to come and destroy me, so I decide, okay, time to move around a bit and try and find some enemies. So I spot the flak panzer here, and the first thing I do is hesitate a lot because it's a flak panzer, it could penetrate you easily. However, I use the knowledge that my armor is completely successful and that he's firing not purple tracers, so he's not firing APCR. So I plant one into him the first time, I ricochet, plant a second one in, he takes out his driver, and I plant a third one in, and I kill him by taking out his gunner. So now I proceed to move up again. I see this dead body over here. I didn't think it was dead at the time, so I switch to my gunner, and I fire machine gun rounds at it, and it blows up, so it's dead. So that's nice. So I look around again, make sure there's nothing near me that can help harm me, and I swear I'm running away from all the bombs in this. Either that or I'm just crazy. But yeah, sorry for the frame loss here, new computer. Well, I'm just kind of doing this. Sorry for the frame loss. New computer should be coming in soon. Yeah. So I climb up the hill, get over here, see if I can spot anything in this general vicinity, since I saw some stuff being pointed out on the map, but I ignored it earlier in the game. Now, once I pop up, I go around this building, and the first thing I see is a Panzer IIIF. I'm not sure if this dude is AFK or what he's doing, but, you know, if it's an opportunity, I'll take it. So I switch to my gunner, plant one into his rear, put it on fire, plant one into his turret, do no damage, and plant another one in, and he's dead. That's just great. Now I see the Crusader get hit by something. It was just the bomb, and I thought it wasn't the bomb, so I proceed to go and look around for something to kill for the rest of this match that hit the Crusader, but absolutely nothing hit the Crusader, and I just spend the rest of this match kind of just, like, just searching for enemies that don't exist. I mean, there isn't anything I can do about it. Now, I see the Panzer IV-E down there. I'm just like, okay, should I kill him? But no, it's too late by the time I get to a good position. And yes, I know our team is spawn camping. I do not endorse spawn camping, so yeah. Anyways, I'm just going to cut this off here. I literally just spent the remainder of this just searching for enemies that I might be able to kill, and I didn't find anything. So I finished that match in third place, 5 kills, and a score of 1,508, which is just great. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please leave a like down below. It encouraged me to keep making this stuff. And if you didn't like the video, dislike it, because that tells me I need to improve my crap. Thank you. If you're new to the channel or you really liked it, please subscribe. That'll help you to, you know, see when I upload my videos. And it also encouraged me to keep making this stuff as well. And if you have any questions, comments, concerns, suggestions for what tanks or aircraft I should fly out next, or play out next, I shouldn't say fly out, because I'm totally going to fly a tank, down in the comment section down below, because that is an awesome place. Believe me. Anyways, guys, I hope you have some good luck out there in the general world. Yeah. Peace, bros.